I'm going to talk about how to truly properly size your solar system, how much power batteries can really store, and the way a solar system really works, because it's pretty amazing how many people that have solar systems don't truly understand how much power they have. And it's important to know, because if you end up with a situation where your modules break, your solar panels aren't functioning for a period of time, or you have a series of cloudy days, it's good to understand exactly how many kilowatt hours you can actually pull out of your battery safely. So how many days and how you can ration your power. And also that really helps you size your system properly with what appliances you're using. So I'm going to start by explaining how the batteries are set up. And I first want to say the caps are off the batteries right now because I'm equalizing. Explain that in another video, but hydrogen gas is escaping right now, and you don't want these caps on while that's happening. So, right here I have 8 DECA LT16 batteries. Now these are 350 amp hour batteries. I'm going to explain, that's part of what I'm going to explain today, what that means. But before I do that, these are set up in 2 strings, parallel together. So we have 4 batteries, a group of 4 batteries that are in series, which means that they're wired from their positive to the negative, positive to the negative, positive to the negative, and then positive to the positive, and negative to the negative over to the next string. When you wire 4 batteries in series, every time you do that, the amperage stays the same, but the volts double. So each of these batteries is 6 volts. So when I put 4 in series, I end up with, essentially, one bigger 24-volt battery. The amps are still the same, though. So what I have here are 2 24-volt batteries, and then they're paralleled together, negative to negative and positive to positive. And when you parallel 2 batteries together, you double the amperage. So I have sized my battery system to make this 24 volts with double the amperage of a single battery. So each of these batteries is 350 amp hours. Okay, so first I want to clarify that when your solar panels on the roof, the electricity that they generate, you're not using that electricity directly. You're never using that electricity directly. Anytime you pull power from a solar system, you're always pulling from the batteries. The solar panels send electricity to the charge controller, and the charge controller reads what the voltage of the battery system is, and maybe even a couple other metrics, and it determines how it should charge these batteries. So if you're using power during the day, depleting power from these batteries, when the sun's out, that electricity from the panels is actually directed into the batteries to charge them. But it's not actually the power that you're using. You're pulling power from the batteries and the solar modules through the charge controller are charging the batteries back up. That's the best way to look at this. So that being said, you only have as much power to use as what's stored in the batteries. Now, I have 4 225-watt modules. And at best, they can produce about 200 watts each when the sun is very much perpendicular to the panels and it's the strongest it's going to be in the sky. So that makes 800 watts. But 800 watts isn't the amount of power I have available. I have far more than that. 800 watts is just the maximum potential of electricity that the charge controller can send to charge these batteries. Now, the way you figure out how much actual electricity you have to use is through the amp hours of these batteries. So let's assume that these batteries have a 100% charge. They're 350 amp hours each. So let's go back and to reference how these batteries are set up. There's 4 batteries in series, 2 pairs of that. And when you do that, you're doubling the volts, but the amps stay the same. So this, each of these strings of batteries are actually still 350 amp hours each, because the amps don't change when you put them in series. I'm doubling the volts every time to reach that 24 volts from the individual 6-volt batteries. So we have 350 amp hours here and 350 amp hours here. Now they're paralleled together, and when you parallel, you're doubling the amps. So what you end up with going to the solar system, to the inverter, and to our DC breaker boxes, we have 700 amp hours of 24 volts of 24-volt DC power available to us at a 100% charge. Now let's talk about what that means. Ohm's law says that watts equals volts times amps. So if we have 24 volts and we have 700 amp hours, this is going to, if we multiply those together, we're going to get watt hours. So if I take 24 and I multiply that by 700, I get 16,800 watt hours. Now, everyone's more familiar with what a kilowatt hour actually is. A kilowatt hour is when you use 1,000 watts for 1 hour. A kilowatt is 1,000 watts. So I have 16,800 watt hours. So what I actually have here, if I divide 16,800 by 1,000, is 16.8 kilowatt hours. And there you go. Everyone's used to seeing kilowatt hour usage on their electricity bill. Now, most people are also saying right now, well, I use far more than that in my home. Well, in your home, you're paying to heat and to cool your house with electricity. Also, your appliances are geared towards a higher consumption home. But in an Earthship, 16.8 kilowatt hours goes a really, really long way. So that's a very important piece of information here. How many kilowatt hours do your batteries have when they're fully charged? So I have almost 17 kilowatt hours in these batteries. Now, I never really want to go on a normal day below 70% usage. So in an average day, I got 16.8, multiply that by 30%. I never really want to use more than 5 kilowatt hours of power out of these batteries a day. Because when you keep them at 70% full at the end of the day, and they sit like that overnight, you're going to experience a really long lifetime with these batteries. But if you start pushing it every day to 50 and 40 and 30 and 20% down, if you actually start using 10, 12, 13, 14 kilowatt hours on this system, you're going to damage these batteries and they're not going to live a long life. These batteries should live about 8 to even 10 years if cared for properly. But you might half that if you take your batteries down to the sub 50% level daily. If you need to use more than 5 kilowatt hours on a system like this per day, you should really expand your system. So, 5 kilowatt hours. There's a reason why 30% of these batteries is 5 kilowatt hours. That's because the system is sized and proportioned in such a way that 5 kilowatt hours is actually the average of what my solar panels on the roof will produce in one normal day. So let's talk about how many hours of sun I have. I have about four hours, maybe even 5 hours of the day where the sun is at its peak and I'm really producing a significant amount of power, anywhere between 500 and 800 watts out of my 800 watt potential from my solar panels. So if we do the math here, I'll say an average of 650 watts I'm producing for 5 hours out of every day. That's the bulk of what I'm producing every day. So I take 650 watts and I multiply that by 5 hours. I get 3,250 watt hours, which is 3.25 kilowatt hours per day of that 5 hour period. But it's also producing power throughout the other hours of the day, just not quite as much. So basically, in an average day in Taos, my four 225 watt rated panels will produce approximately 5 kilowatt hours. So if I use 5 kilowatt hours in a day, get down to 30%, the next day my modules will fully charge, will make up for that usage. But I'm sizing my house not at 5 kilowatt hours. I'm sizing my appliances to use more like 3.5 kilowatt hours per day. That's my fridge and any AC devices I have. That's my lights. That is my my washing machine, and my computer, things like that. So I am sizing everything to use 3.5 kilowatt hours per day. That's somewhere around 20% of what my batteries can hold. And that ensures that the next day I will more than top out these batteries. I will fully charge them and they will get to a float state, which means it's just a trickle charge. And that's really where you want to be. So if some days I use more than 3.5 kilowatt hours, I use more like 5, even 6 or 7, or even 10 some days, that's fine. But on an average day, I'm using 3.5 kilowatt hours. And that's what I want to kind of try to stay around.